Carmen Wilderness was founded in 1939 by Ken and Susan Webb, and very much was founded on some Quaker ideals that the light of every person is equally important. And as the world around us changes, we change as well, but very much stay focused on a simple lifestyle, on the value.
My thesis is how Farm and Wilderness has affected my friends' lives. These are the people I interviewed and how long they've gone to camp.
Caden Sharp, 6 years, IBNTF.
Skittles, Timberlake, and Tamarack Farm.
Connor Ambrose,
5 summers.
I'm Timber Donahue.
I went starting when I was 12 until I was 15. I started off at Flying Cloud and moved on to Tamarack Farm.
I then asked them what their favorite part of camp was, and this is what they said.
Silent meeting is really good. Silent meeting is a period every day where the whole community gets together and sits around in a circle. Everyone's in view of everyone else, and you sit in silence and just have a given time period of just simple reflection. And if someone is moved to speak, they can say anything that's on their mind and have it heard throughout the entire community, and everyone has a chance to just take a moment and sit back and listen to silence or have inner reflection time about a number of things. Sort of like a check for yourself, almost. It's like a time for you to sit back and really pause from the everyday, like, and not everyday drama, but everyday, like, routine and the stuff that you have to do. You have a chance to sit back and really just really think and ponder and question everything, and it helps a lot to clear your thoughts in your head.
Actually, I really dig silent meetings, funny story, and I also really dig morning songs. I actually miss, like, I mean, singing is something I do more than anything else, like, ever. Like, for example, in, like, my photo class, like, I go into the dark room and I'll just kind of, like, burst into the room, like, singing some shitty song.
Growing up in an environment that's safe, and kind of learning acceptance and not really having to worry about anything.
I think the freedom I was given, you know, at Flying Cloud especially, we were allowed to walk out into the woods by ourselves and just kind of go. It's really nice to be able to just kind of whenever I wanted just walk.
You
can go wherever I wanted, and I felt so responsible for myself.
Yeah.
Felt really good.
Do you like the fact that camp doesn't allow us to bring our cell phones or iPods?
Hell yeah. I hate that shit. Like, I use them all the time. Like, honestly, like, if I had texting, I'd probably do it every 3 seconds of my life. I don't have texting because I texted too much and I got it taken away from me, but, like, I'm on Facebook, like, every day.
Absolutely. In my physics class, we were talking about how teenagers are so wired these days, and, like, people can't put down their cell phone and, like, take a step back from the technological world that we live in, and it's true, we can't, but, it's really liberating, actually, to be able to live, like, actually organic.
Yeah. I didn't think there was any way I could live without my iPod.
Yeah.
But I found out some amazing things about myself.
Mm.
And I think everyone should try that.
Can you talk about how Farm and Wilderness has affected your life?
It really does just help you have a new sense of, like, self-reliance when you can go away from your family for 2 months.
Yeah.
Or a month, or however long you go away. And I think that, you know, the responsibility I learned is another big part. And you can learn that pretty much wherever you go if you go there alone.
So it definitely builds, or definitely prepares you to become an adult, right?
Exactly.
I feel like F&W creates a kind of area where everybody really not only learns but understands what it means to, like, work together with people.
Yeah.
So it's like, I feel like people learn, like, what it means to pick up the slack, what it means to help others, what it means to want to help others, and how your role in a community is important to everyone else's.
You know, you always could count on, like, you would only spend 2 months with these people, you know, 1 or 2 months with these people, and you would leave, and, like, every time I left, I would cry, just because you felt like you were leaving your family, whereas, like, you know, you spend, like, 4 years with people in high school, and then you leave, and you just, you know, I can already predict I'm going to leave, and I'm going to forget about most of these people, but
it was just something about the environment there. I don't know what it was, but, like, you know, it just, it creates a sort of brotherhood. It created some sort of, I don't know, like, I value those years more than, like, any other years of my life, just because I feel like I learned something about, like, loving my brothers and, like, really just appreciating, like, you know, just guy time, I guess. Just really get into these moments and, like, I don't know, like, you know, just amazing, like, even if these memories don't sound, like, great, if, you know, to anyone who wasn't there, I will, you know, I'll always remember that one moment where, like, we were all, I don't know why, I just remember, like, at that one moment, I thought, like, I'm gonna remember this, because this is, like, I don't think I'll ever be as happy.
Say tonight, fight the breakup, don't come tomorrow, tomorrow I'll be gone. Say tonight, fight the breakup, don't come tomorrow, tomorrow I'll be gone. There's a log on the fire, and it burns like me for you. Tomorrow comes with one desire, to take me away from the truth. It ain't easy to say goodbye.